Hey, how you guys doing?
Hey, go ahead quickly. You're on the air.
You know, talking about the takers and the, you know, there's a lot of folks who find themselves in a bind where it's hard to help. We've got a system. Myself is to some degree in this, being a disabled veteran. I haven't been able to get a medical release to work in going on, I think, 9 years now. You know, if you can't get a medical release to work, your options become quickly limited.
Sure.
Because no employer's insurance company is going to let them hire you. That's a big thing, and it can be overcome. I mean, get creative. I'm making extra income now aside from all that, but it's a real challenge for a lot of folks because we're limited by this system that you can't do a whole lot of things, you know, legally, certainly. And I wouldn't encourage people to go out and say, hey, become a drug dealer so you're doing something off the books. But, you know, it's a real challenge for a lot of folks. It's when you can't get out and work.
I would encourage people to do anything they can that's off the books. I mean, obviously there's risk involved. And there's different levels of risk depending on what off-the-books activity we're talking about here. But, you know, even now you don't even have to be a prostitute. You can snuggle with people and get $60 an hour. I mean, I don't know if everybody can get away with that, but, you know, there are people who are doing that. You said you're sure you couldn't?
Yeah, I'm sure nobody would pay me $60 an hour to snuggle with them. If they would, just, you know, look me up.
Sign me up.
It's a real challenge that a lot of people face. And yeah, to some degree, I would definitely encourage, hey, you know what? If you got to violate some laws in civil disobedience, do so.
What do you think is more likely? Do you think it's more likely we're going to move, that you know, somehow we're going to move to a smaller government where there are a few takers on the dole? Or do you think that the federal government's just going to collapse of its own weight?
Well, I think it's pretty obvious, especially at least with Mark. You know, I think the government's going to collapse under its own weight. I think the dollar's going to collapse.
Yeah, there's no chance the federal government's going to turn around and become more small government. It's ridiculous to believe that.
There's no chance it's going to shrink. Our dollar is so incredibly burdened down with debt and the printing policies and everything else.
They're going to scratch all of the money out of the dollar. They're going to siphon as much value out of the dollar as they possibly can all the way to the bitter, bitter end, whatever it is that looks like. And they're going to line their pockets all the way based on everybody else's pain and loss. That's how it's going to go.
That question was a softball. This is Billy Cooper, author of Crashed, the Death of the Dollar.
Yes.
Yeah.
Cool.
I just wanted to mention.
Hey, yeah, I'm the author of that book, so quite obviously, yes, I think the dollar is going to collapse. I see it as inevitable. And
Billy, where do people get your book?
You know, they can get it at Amazon, Barnes and Noble's, all over the place.
Free Talk Live, 7 nights a week from 7 to 10 Eastern, live on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.